Hello friends, hope you are doing good. So in this video I will show you how to convert any picture into a logo, or you could say how to convert any image with a transparent background. So here I'm having few images with me, so I will just open it to show you. Just to show you, this is a logo with blue background and this is my signature, and I'm having few images, so I will just convert it into logo. Or you could say a picture with a transparent background. So let's start. So here I'm opening Microsoft Word. I will just create an environment in the Microsoft Word so that you could able to notice the changes in the image. So here I'm just going to the shapes and I will just select the whole area of the page. And further, I'll just put one color to the shape. Okay, this is fine. So anyway, now I will transport one image to this Word. So I will just import the image. Let's say I will just import this picture. This is my own picture. So I will just bring it in the front of this image. I mean this shape. So I will click on bring to front. So now this image will be on the top of this Word sheet. As you could see, this image is having white background, but not the transparent background. So now I will show you how I will convert this image with transparent background. I mean that white background will become transparent. So for that, I will just open up my web browser, and this is the link. I will just paste it in the notepad so that you could have a better look on it. I will just maximize the font size. Anyway, I will put it into the description of the video. Okay, so now I will start the process for converting the background into transparent. First of all, here you could see the upload option. Just click on it and select the image from the device, I mean the computer. You need to go to the preferred location where the image has been kept. So I'm taking this logo for the first time to check it out to make you understand in a better manner, because this logo is having the blue background. So now I am going to convert this blue background into transparent. I mean, there will be no color at all. So you need to go to edit, go to transparent background, just click on it and it will load again. And whatever the color you want to make as a transparent, you want to convert into transparent, you just need to click on that color. So here I need to remove blue color. So it will just create a transparent background wherever that color is present in the image, except this bounded region. As you could see, changes then occurred in these two bounded regions. For applying changes to these regions, repeat the same process two times. For the first time, you need to click on this. So I got the transparent background in this bounded region. Now again, repeat the same process. Just go to edit, transparent background, and then click on this bounded region. So now I got a proper transparent image. So I will just click on save to save the image. Hit OK. And here is the location. I will just open up the folder. And this is the image. I will just cut it from this location and I will paste it here. I'm creating a new folder. And I will just rename this as a logo. So here I have pasted the logo part which I have created from that website. So as you could see, it is not having any background. Now quickly I will import this image which I have downloaded to this Word file to show you the changes. So this is the file which I have downloaded. Now it has been imported to this Word file. I need to bring this to front. Okay, as you could see, everything is transparent. Only the letters is visible and remaining all the other things are transparent. Wherever I'm keeping this picture, it is you can able to look from the bounded region or around the written alphabets. So this is how you can create a transparent background of an image. So it's very simple, no need of Photoshop or no need of any high level tools to create any transparent background image. You can even create your signature with a blank background so that you can keep it anywhere in the Word document. Look, this is my signature. So I will just go and do the same steps what I have done previously. Here also bounded regions are there. So first of all, outer region will be removed. And then again, I need to follow the same procedure. I need to do the same thing, edit transparent background. And again, I need to click on one of the bounded region. So this time I will click on this part. As you could see, but still there are five bounded regions remaining. So one by one you can just select it and create a transparency for that particular reason. So it is very easy, like people are doing Adobe Photoshop. So maximum people don't know how to use Photoshop. So this is the best method how you could use this, how you could make the image background into a transparent. So it requires some more time. This is the simple thing, just you need to click it again and again to achieve the transparency on each region. So I'm just going to fast forward this part. Because it is having more bounded regions, it will take some time. So that's why, for saving time, I will just fast forward it. And the last one here. Okay, it's done now. So all the region has been converted into a transparent background. As you could see, now it is a proper transparent background signature. And I will save it as I have done previously. And here is the downloaded image. I will go to the folder. I'll just cut it from this location and paste it to this folder. Okay, so as you could see, this is the image. And now quickly I will import it to here so that you could see the changes. And now I will change it, bring it to front. You could see this signature is now transparent and you can place it anywhere. It will look like original. So it is very easy and you can create any image with a transparent background, and wherever you place this image, you will get that texture in the background. So likewise, I will try this also and this also, but these two images are having many bounded regions, so it will take more time to create the transparent image of these two images. Anyway, I'm going to try it out. You can just wait and watch on your screen. I think the size of this image is pretty bigger, that's why it is taking some time to get uploaded. So anyway, it got uploaded. I'm repeating the same procedure. I will just do it very quickly without wasting any time. So I have clicked on that region. And that region is converted into transparent background. So I'm going to fast forward this full procedure. You can do it in the same manner. Just to show you, I will just fast forward it and show you the final result in the end. So as you could see, this is the final result. Anyway, I will not save this image, and I will just upload the final image, which is a real image which has been clicked from a camera. So let's check whether this technique works on this type of images or not. So I'm doing the same procedure. It has loaded now. I have clicked on white part, and as you could see, all the white part in the picture became transparent. And now I will save it. I will just go to the folder location where it got downloaded. I will just open the folder location and cut the file from that location, paste it into the logo folder. Okay, so this is the final image, which is having a transparent background. I will just show you the difference of image which is not having a transparent background and image with a transparent background. I will just bring it front. Okay, you could see both are same images with two different backgrounds. One is transparent and one is the fixed background. So like this, you can create any image with a transparent background, and you could use it as logo, so it looks like sticker. So by using this simple method, you can convert any image with a transparent background. Anyway, as I told you previously, you can put an image as an icon. So here I will set my own image as my computer icon, but still I haven't converted into .ico image. So right now what I'm having is the PNG extension of this image which I have created from here. So I will just open up the icon conversion website. So this is the website which I told you previously in my earlier videos. So I will just open up this website. It's quite slow. Okay, anyway, I will just upload the PNG image with a transparent background which I have downloaded, and it got uploaded now. So I will just select the area. Oh, sorry. Okay, now the area is selected, and let me just stretch it out. Okay, it's done now. This image is in perfect square. So now I will just convert ICO, and the file is ready. I will just download it. So here it is. Okay, it is downloaded now. I will just open up the download folder. I will just cut the image from this location, and I will put it on the desktop. Oh no, I don't want to place it on the desktop. I will just put it inside logo folder. Okay, as you could see, I'm having the icon format in my logo folder, and I have opened the personalized desktop image settings. Here I will change the icon of my computer with my image which I have downloaded just now. So as you could see, I need to apply it. As soon as I will apply, you could see the changes on the left-hand side top corner of the screen. This icon will get changed with my image. You can see. So now if I will click on it, it will open this PC in Windows 10 or my computer in Windows 7. So this is how you can customize the icon also. So that's it for today. So if you like the video, please do like, share, and subscribe my channel for the latest update. And do press the bell icon to get quick notification. Or for any queries, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And I will try, if you're having any recommendation for my video, please do recommend that also in the comment section below, which I will try to implement in my next video or upcoming videos. Thank you. See you again in the next video. Bye bye.